Okay, so hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I have changed it up with the books at the moment because I'm running out of space on my other phone to record these book reviews because every time I'm reading quite quickly and I'm running out of space. So when I do get an unboxing, I don't have enough space, so I have to upload a video, which I don't want to upload that video on that day until a different day. So it's kind of a bit complicated. So I have decided to film it on this phone and do it this way for like the same way I'll do my DVD reviews. But it's going to be this way just for a little bit. I don't know how long it will be, but it's going to be filmed this way. So I do apologise, but that's how it's going to be. So what's going to happen is I am going to do four videos into one because this is the Folk of Air series. So I do have the Wicked King, the Queen of Nothing, and How the King of Elfhame learned hate stories. Do I have those? So those are going to be into one video. Same with any other series, duologies, trilogies, anything. So like Ember of the Ashes, Serpent and Dove, Daughter of the Smoke and Bone, Court series, the Throne of Glass series. All those will be put into one video just to make it more easier for me. And I don't have to worry about trying to get it all up and try and figure out how to do it. So what I'm going to do is I will of course leave the timestamps down below for when the books have been up and shown. You can easily just skip them to those ones if you want to hear about those reviews, or you watch the whole video anyway. So that was just a quick little thing. So we're going to go into The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. Beautiful design. We have the crown on the tree branch, and then we have this little bug. And then here's the little back. I don't have to read this because you can easily just pause it and read it, or you might have read it already. So I do have these three books as well, which will go through the series as well. So here we go. So The Cruel Prince follows Jude, a human girl living among fairies. She wants to fit in, but her stubbornness and determination causes her to stand out among the royal family, where she aspires to become a knight. Jude has a twin sister, Tyrone, I hope I said her name right, an older knit sister named Vivian, who is a fairy. Vivian and Jude are both very, very, very rebellious, sorry, I could not say that, and try their hardest to get what they want, no matter the circumstances, when Tyrone is more of a people pleaser. Ouch. The book has a very dramatic beginning, as Jude's parents were killed and the three girls are taken from the mortal world to the fairy world. Jude has many enemies from the royal family in this new place, which sets the stage for eventful chapters. They rarely a dull moment throughout the entire book, and the storyline is fast-paced and some hard to keep up with. Jude seems to have a lot of changing goals throughout the book. With these two new characters being introduced, it was a little confusing to keep up with everything Jude was trying to accomplish and who became her friend or stayed her enemy. Most of the characters are spunky and have their own rebellious personalities, but some many conspiring groups with different goals. It was hard to tell exactly where Jude fell in and what her plans were. The mystery of the final outcome, however, was enjoyable to read along with. It was an interesting addition to the plot that Jude had blatantly, obviously, struggled in the book that didn't get any better for a while. She had to work really hard with the minimal support to come out the top. It didn't feel like the whole hero always wins scenario. The book is written from Jude's her side of the story. So it was neat to understand her motives and her constant butting heads with the royal family, and what her experience was when she misunderstood and underestimated by her family. Overall, The Cruel Prince is a great fantasy novel with an action-packed plot. The characters have very relatable personalities, and although the main idea shifts towards the end, this book is made for a good, intriguing book for the entire reader. Ending. So I do full-on love reading this. I enjoyed it so much, and I just can't wait to see how there's going to be another one about it, because it was just so cool to learn about something like this, and it was interesting, guys. So next up, we do have The Wicked King, and by Holly Black as well, so see you in a bit on that one. Okay, so we're back with The Wicked King by Holly Black as well, and I'm really excited to get into this book. So Here's the back of here as well. Like I said, I don't have to really read these because, well, you can read them yourself. So I love this book cover as well, the crown in the underwater and the splashing up of the water up there. And just to tell us how Cardin became the Wicked King, pretty much. But 5 months after the Cruel Prince ended, Jude is all now worrying that her time to control Cardin is almost at the end. She has commanded him to never hurt her, but he might be able to work around that. There's a court meeting. A smith called Grimson seeks refuge in Cardin's kingdom. Cardin asks him to swear to an oath to him, but Grimson says he would rather show loyalty in other ways. Cardin agrees and Grimson becomes part of the court. I don't think this was a good idea, but whatever. We think we know why. Jude takes a prison card called, Balsigpa, I can't say his name, say the person's name, back to the Court of Shadows because he's loyal to the Balakin. She threatens to kill him if he doesn't tell her why Balakin wants to talk to Cardin. The prison card doesn't know, but he does reveal that the Queen of Ugla of the Undersea has been sending messages to the Balakin. I hope I said those names right. Don't know. Nicasia admits to try and assassinate Cardin, but she says it's because she wants to seduce Cardin and find another woman in his bed. Nisaka, the person, she, was allegedly trying to kill the other woman. Jude asks her what her mother, Oglag, is planning. She says that her mother's planning to marry her to Cardin, and if Cardin refuses, then she will, her mother will flood the kingdom. Sorry, I literally just full on moved the camera a lot there. Oh, so the Living Council holds a meeting. They summon Jude and they tell her they want to advise Cardin as they can. They're his council and he refuses to come to the meetings. They point out that Cardin's rule is affecting the kingdom and storms are starting to come in faster. And the subjects are getting tipsy when he drinks. The council doesn't listen to Jude's concerns about Orla. Locke makes a big deal about Jude coming up to accept a crown for the Queen of Mirth, and Jude goes along with it. Jude asks if the old woman was grabbed Jude in the prison can forgive false information on Oak and therefore protected him from Orla. I can't say her name. The old woman is Lady Esha, Cardin's mother. Did not expect that one. Oopsie. Cardin gets information on Orlag and her plan to attack during Tyrion's wedding. Jude threatens Locke for his antics at the party. She said if he tries to undermine her again, she will kill him. There's so many like interesting parts. I was like, I had to write all these down. So Jude is put in the cage and starved. Jude still pretends to be the glamoured. A month or so later, they take Jude back to the surface. Jude is taken to Maverick's house. So this is after he betrayed her. Jude buys a dress from the local market. Mother Marrow is there and offers to trade Jude's earrings for a walnut with a dress inside. Ta-da! Cardin kisses Jude in front of everyone. Jude takes poison on his lips. Balakin tries to tell everyone that Jude poisoned the king using the poison he gave to her as proof. Jude reveals that the glamour hasn't been working. She tells the crowd that Cardin is just drunk. Jude kills Balakin in a duel. And then Jude goes to live with Vivian and Oak in the human realm. Jude starts to plan how to get back into the fair realm. She plans to find Grimson and have him make a crown for Oak. Vivian suggests that Jude teams up with Madric and Jude to consider it. And oh my god, guys. It was just intense. Just reading those little marks since. Yes, I know I read a lot. But to be honest, I didn't know what else to put in it because I was like, oh my god, it's so flipping good. I want to find out what happened more in the book. So anyway, of course, next up we have the Queen of Nothing. So, let's just do swapsy on that one. Okay, we're back for the Queen of Nothing, guys. So, me being epically fail at everything, of course. This is the next book. So I've only written a little bit of this book because I totally forgot to write rest more of it. So I have actually read all these books like 2 weeks ago, and I've written down my info on it, so that's why I sound like I'm reading, because I am reading off it. So this is the final of the Folk of Air trilogy, by Holly Black. After being pronounced the Queen of Fairies and then abruptly exiled by the Wicked King Cardin, Jude finds herself and more the Queen of Nothing. She spends her time with Vivian and Oak and watches her fair share of the reality television and does the odd jobs or two, including to try and convince a cannibalistic fairy from hunting her own in the mortal world. When her twin sister Tyrone shows up asking for a favour, Jude jumps at the chance to return to the fairy world. Even it means facing Cardin. When a dark curse is veiled, Jude must become the first mortal queen of fairies and uncover how to break the curse or risk upsetting the balance of the world. Fairy world. So broken people, complicated fairies, family, magic and fairy politics. Black's back and whenever you came for the law or the love perfection. So this is out of anywhere. Jude's protagonist is also just so refreshing. She's ruthless but very vulnerable. Unapologetic about defending herself and her throne upon death if necessary, even against her adopted father. It's not often I see young women written with both emotional depths and competitive brutality that Jude balances herself inside herself. And even rare to see those young women allowed to fall in love and negate a functional partnership with shared control. That's the sort of thing that draws me to these books. These will got to him. I wasn't just disappointed at any of the stage of the story at all, because it just got my. It was just really intriguing to like read, see how it come to, and everything like that. So I really enjoyed this book. So next up, we have the last of the kind of thing, and this is how the King of Elfhame Learned to Hate Stories. So more of Cardin's side. Okay, so finally we have this. When I got this, I was like, ooh, this is a really pretty cover. Did not expect to be inside these pictures. Look at these covers. Look. These are so pretty. Like, you have this artwork inside. It's different. I'm not even in the camera. Brilliant. And you have these chapters that look like this. You know, and just so pretty. Like, look at that one. This artwork is amazing and I full on enjoyed it. I love that. Look at that. Look how cute that looks. But you can see that this is all flowing around the Wicked King himself. So this is, once upon a time, there was a boy with a wicked king, with a wicked tongue. Before he was a cruel prince or wicked king, he was a fair child with a heart of stone. So this is basically just telling him the story of Cardin, his perspective of this, of his side of the story, of when he was a boy to how he becomes now of a pretty much a douchebag in the stories, but he's so, it's like, don't you ever like, don't you fall for the guy that's like mean and horrible and evil, and you're like, oh, I like that guy, but don't expect to like the other guy. Yeah, that's how I felt. I like Cardin. His attitude was amazing, guys. So anyway, that was the 4 books of the series. So I hope you guys enjoyed these. Like I said, I will be doing it to other series as well. If they have a duology or a trilogy or whatever comes to it, I will be doing that as well. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time, because the next book will be April Fool by Sarah Hannan. Bye-bye.